You can have it. My brother comes home from work and climbs the stairs to our room. I can hear the bed groan and his shoes drop one by one. You can have it, he says. The moonlight streams in the window and his unshaven face is whitened like the face of the moon. He will sleep long after noon and waken to find me gone. 30 years will pass before I remember that moment when suddenly I knew each man has one brother who dies when he sleeps and sleeps when he rises to face this life, and that together they are only one man, sharing a heart that always labors, hands yellowed and cracked, a mouth that gasps for breath and asks, am I gonna make it? All night at the ice plant, he had fed the chute its silvery blocks. And then I stacked cases of orange soda for the children of Kentucky, one gray boxcar at a time, with always two more waiting. We were 20 for such a short time, and always in the wrong clothes, crusted with dirt and sweat. I think now we were never 20. In 1948, in the city of Detroit, founded by Delamothe Cadillac for the distant purposes of Henry Ford, no one wakened or died. No one walked the streets or stoked a furnace. For there was no such year. And now that year has fallen off all the old newspapers, calendars, doctor's appointments, bonds, wedding certificates, driver's licenses. The city slept. The snow turned to ice, the ice to standing pools or rivers racing in the gutters. Then bright grass rose between the thousands of cracked squares, and that grass died. I give you back 1948. I give you all the years from then to the coming one. Give me back the moon with its frail light falling across a face. Give me back my young brother, hard and furious, with wide shoulders and a curse for God, and burning eyes that look upon all creation and say, you can have it.